Alright, I am in this Honda Big Wing Ashoka Nagar, going for a test ride, and this gentleman is helping me, sitting on this 500cc motorcycle after a long time. Let's go. Okay, I don't feel I am riding a 500cc motorcycle. Very good weight distribution, good work guys. Oh man, this motorcycle looks very cool. Let me stop here. So it's a negative display, pretty decent one. And this does not have all the electronics in the world, like the all your KTMs or Kawasaki's or Triumph. This is very decent motorcycle. Good, smooth, refined engine and pickup. Very good man. I really love this particular motorcycle. When it comes to Honda, I really love the Honda engines, how it feels. But I need to get adjusted to this horn. If you see, the horn is placed in the middle. Usually for all the motorcycles, the horn will be placed somewhere here. But yes, this is kind of something which we need to get adjusted to. Oh man, so smooth. Awesome. Oh, it reaches 80 kilometers in no time. I don't feel like I'm riding in high speeds. Having said that, just test riding in cities like some 4 to 5 kilometers will not tell you the whole story of the bike. So this is kind of an initial impression of the bike, and let's see how this bike looks from outside. I'll just park here for some time. I know this is not the right place to park, but I just want to show you guys how this bike looks. And if you see the seat, so this has around 830 or 840 mm, I think. I can easily ground both of my toes. And this is how my Dominar also feels. And this motorcycle is very, very light, guys. One of the main qualities of adventure tourer is it should be light and nimble. That is what I believe. But all different people have different perspectives. But if your motorcycle is very heavy, right, and it is very difficult to handle the motorcycle, especially during off-roading and other things where you literally have to lift your bike if it falls down. So all those kind of things. If your motorcycle is light, then it's an added advantage. This is how the motorcycle looks. Pretty decent one. I know the camera is not doing the justice, but this is looking like a big adventure tourer motorcycle. I don't want to read out all the specs of the motorcycle, guys. I know people are smart enough to get it on online, but yes. And one advantage of this is it has fuel tank capacity of 17.7 liters. Being a 500cc motorcycle, if you have 17.7 liters, I think that's a good bet. Because as your number of cc increases, the fuel consumption rate increases, right? So for 500cc motorcycle, I think 17.7 does a good job if you're going for a long tour. And it's a parallel twin, by the way. So you don't feel those kind of vibrations
as you feel in most of the single cylinder motorcycle. But I think once you hit 110 or 120 the vibration starts, which I don't know, but I have to kind of test it out. Absolutely loving this motorcycle. I have to tell what most of the YouTubers or most of the people who are talking about Honda CB500X, pricing of this motorcycle, I think it's around 8.67, so above 8.5 lakhs on-road price. But guys, wait, let's do the math. Let's say you buy a Versys 650 or a Suzuki V-Strom 650, which are similar segment motorcycles but offer much more. Honda initial cost can be more, but the maintenance of this bike is very, very, very cheap as compared to its rivals, Kawasaki's or the Triumphs or the Suzuki's. The aftermarket or the after purchase maintenance of this motorcycle is equal to a typical Dominar, maybe slightly higher than that, but not equivalent to the Triumphs or the Kawasaki's or the BMWs. And I'm going to check about the brake pads and other rates. I am not sure about the exact rate, but I think average service cost is equivalent to those kind of bikes, the Dominar and the KTMs, right? Even I would be happy if it was somewhere placed between 7.5 to 8 lakh on-road price, but yeah, it's just 50 to 60,000 more. But yes, if you love Honda engines, you got to pay for this and you got to take this. There is no substitute for that. Yeah, most of the people compare this motorcycle with KTM 390 Adventure, which costs about 4 lakh on-road, and this is double the price, and that has all the electronics in the world, everything. Please don't compare this motorcycle with its KTMs or other motorcycles which has traction control, switchable ABS and all those sorts of electronics. Just understand, guys, once you buy a motorcycle, you don't worry about mileage, you don't worry about all the electronics. 98% of the times what matters is how is the ride quality, right? So ride quality matters a lot. If you're going for a long tour and if you ride 7-8 hours a day, after reaching the destination you should not feel pain in your body, right? The ride quality matters a lot. I'm not promoting Honda anyways, but that's what I feel. This is my analysis, guys. Let me know what you guys feel. If the gentleman agree for giving me this bike for the long test ride, then yes, I'll definitely review this bike, everything, the windscreen, wind resistance and other things. After riding Honda, when I get back on Dominar, my bike feels little bit vibey. And yeah, the refinement, my bike feels little less refined. But yes, obviously Dominar is best in its own segment. But yes, I am a big lover of Honda engines, guys. That is why my motivation to come and review this motorcycle. Just a small note, I'm not a professional bike reviewer, so this is my first review, in fact, on YouTube. If you guys have any comments or suggestions, feel free to let me know. And the gentleman from the showroom, Ayush, he told me the front brake pad of a Honda CB500X just cost you 1500, both front and back. Less than that, in fact. So in that way, the maintenance of your bike is very cheap compared to the other rivals or its other friends, I would say, not rivals, like the Kawasaki's or Triumph or Suzuki. But they have their own advantages. Always, if you're paying more money, you will get good features for sure. But yes, this is the quality of Honda. Initial cost may be a little bit high. That's the same story with the CB300 also. And Honda engines are the engines that you can trust. You cannot review the bike by riding it like 3-4 kilometers, right? That too only in third gear maximum. I didn't even put the fourth gear on this bike. Some people do that even in cities, but yeah, I'm not that kind of person. I don't want to pull in the motorcycle, which is not my motorcycle first of all, and ride it in like hundreds or 120s in the city. But yeah, if I get a chance to review this motorcycle on highways, long review, then definitely I'll make justice to the review. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and do consider subscribing if you like the content. See you guys in the next one. Take care, bye bye, and happy Dasara. See you.